question, how has One Belt, One Road affected the relations between China and America in Asia and Africa? So first, let me give the definition of One Belt, One Road. One Belt, One Road is an extremely significant project which was proposed by the Chinese government. It was a vital event undertaken by the government on 2019, August 27th, as you can see on the PPT. And the new sector focuses on improving connectivity and cooperation among multiple countries in Asia, Africa, and Europe. Okay, next, let's talk about some backgrounds. One Belt, One Road, undertaken by the Chinese government, has made some difference to the political relationship between China and America. Since a very early age, America has taken its dominant role in the world and it wants to maintain its position through centuries. By contrast, the existence of One Belt, One Road rendered various countries to become partners of China. And this is somehow harmful to America's political position, because through One Belt, One Road, more and more countries began to cooperate with China. So, America has taken some actions, and that's the background. And next, next is Ali's turn.
First of all, let me introduce the contents of our group presentation. First, we will talk about the impact of OBOR on Asia and Africa, and then we will talk about the impact of the United States on Asia, and finally show the relationship between China and the U.S. Actually, China has a great impact on Africa. From this map, we can see that both Djibouti and Kenya are African countries, so we can infer that Eastern Africa has developed into a central node in the maritime Silk Road. Also, Chinese experts argue that this strategy would have two main applications in Africa. For most, Africa is the country lack of the infrastructure development. So through the OBOR, it can stress their infrastructure and increase their trade with each other. Also, second is transfer the labor-intensive market to Africa, especially manufacturing business. Since China's manufacturing costs continue to rise, part of China's effort to mitigate this effect will also go to Africa. In order to carry out infrastructure projects, China has sent a large number of professional personnel into Africa, which has subsequently improved the technical levels in African countries and led to technological upgrade. Moreover, a large number of infrastructure construction is also improved the development of the African countries. That's its primary part.
So I will introduce that the One Belt World's impact in Asia. And you can see the picture in the PowerPoint is the railway in the Northeast. And China also built many railways in the South West Asia. And there's a question, why China built this railway? And what can it bring? Firstly, I want to say that this can increase the profit and increase the productivity and decrease the cost on the company. So in this case, the investment from abroad are more willing to build the factory and build investment on this business. And secondly, the railway in the road that connects with the inside land and port in the coast. And so that these countries can open the market abroad. And there's a similar case in China. In the last century, in 1980s, China also built many railways, and it is one of the main factors that boost the China economies. And these things are happened and are going to happen in the countries that in the One Belt, One Road. Next, please. And I will also introduce how the U.S. impact in Asia. And you can see the first picture is about Japan. As everybody knows that Japan has a close relationship with the U.S. And in the Meiji period, the Japan government as a
like the tariff imposed on Pakistan by America. We can easily see that America is trying to support China from going into an extremely strong country. Originally, American President Donald Trump has declared that we would be a reliable proponent of China's project. However, the actual situation turns out to be the opposite. America has done numerous options to slow the progress of One Belt, One Road. The actual reason which motivates America to do so is that the One Belt, One Road program has raised America's political position. In fact, through One Belt, One Road, one more countries depend more on China instead of America. In the past, these countries couldn't live without essential care offered by America. However, this situation changes a lot due to the implementation of One Belt, One Road. So, in order to ensure its development and practice politics, America has no way but disagreeing with the Chinese project. On the other hand, if we look at the side of China, due to the interpretation of America, this will ultimately result in a worse relationship between these two powerful nations. And next, Emily will give a conclusion.
As you can see in the August Winter War, the two countries like the US and China all want to expand their power and raise their political position in the global world. And in the today's situation, the two largest countries just compete with each other and putting limitations with each other. And I want to say that the only situation to make the battle worse is the two largest countries can cooperate with each other and help each other be better and move the economy growth in a proper way.